a major milestone for NASA.
Touchdown. I repeat, DDL, FRC has touchdown.
Space Agency finally has its hands on an asteroid sample 7 years after launching to space. A NASA spacecraft delivered a capsule containing the sample early on Sunday morning. And we are told that that capsule contains dust and rocks from the asteroid. Scientists will now spend years studying the rare cosmic gift, hoping to understand the details about the origins of the solar system. With us at the table, astrophysicist Jana Levin. She's also a professor of physics and astronomy at Barnard College of Columbia University and the author of the book, Black Hole Survival Guide. Good morning.
Morning.
I geeked out reading a lot on this morning. It's super interesting. Phil just wants to say the actual name.
OSIRIS-REx.
Yes, whatever that
OSIRIS-REx.
Is.
OSIRIS-REx. It's a very long acronym.
But it's amazing what it was able to do.
It is incredible because the material on this asteroid, we think, is much more similar to how the solar system was when it first formed 4.5 billion years ago. So it actually came from an asteroid belt that's between Mars and Jupiter. And we know we have this image of asteroid belts as being very dense and you can't navigate through, but we've sent spacecraft through. It's not that bad. But it is dense enough that there are collisions, and this asteroid was cast out and is now in a near-Earth orbit around the sun. So we were able to get to it easily, but it has this kind of ancient rock and material.
What's the first thing? So this, they have this in hand.
Yeah.
Probably not literally in your hands, but in some capacity. What are they doing right now? Like, this is a years-long process, I presume.
Yes.
What are they first trying to find out?
So the first thing they've done is they've moved it to a green room locally in Utah where they collected it. I should say the spacecraft was about a third of the way to the moon when it sent it to Earth, this capsule. And then it jettisoned away. So the capsule came on its own, and it was recovered, and it's 120 pounds. So it was carried, first helicoptered, and then put on a cart, literally, and then moved into the Johnson Space Center in Houston, where it's going to be divvied up a little bit among scientists and studied to see if there are these kind of precious amino acids that we think might have launched life here on Earth. So it's unclear if Earth had what it takes to initiate life on its own without asteroids bringing material to initiate the entire process.
This might sound like a dumb question. How did it get the rocks and the dirt? Like, you've got this asteroid and you've got this spacecraft. Does it land, scoop them up, take off?
Yeah, it's a great question because it's really quite small. It's only a few hundred meters across, and it's really more of a kind of collection of debris that's loosely stuck together, a little bit of gravity. And so what the spacecraft did is it dropped down really fast, and it stuck down a little probe to kind of kick up dust purposefully, gather some material, and pop off again. It didn't stay. It was a flyby. It was a drop, a punch, and then it left. And so it happened to get enough material, and the whole thing turned out to be rockier than we expected, looser than we expected. It really penetrated right into the soil as though there wasn't any solid surface. So even that part, which happened in 2020, was quite amazing.
Yeah.
It's remarkable. How quickly do you think people will have a sense of if it has the answers in terms of the amino acid?
It's a great question. We do have theories, techniques to study the amino acids to see if water is sealed inside. But there are certainly probably some tests and things we haven't even thought of. When we look at the Apollo mission bringing back moon rocks, we did not know there was water trapped in these rocks until 40 years later. There were scientists who hadn't been born when the collections were first made who invented techniques to study them in the labs. This is very much, if you hear the NASA scientists talk about it, they're saying, in the future, there are scientists not yet born who will study these rocks.
And it goes on now to do this again at another asteroid, right?
Yes, it's on its way to another asteroid, and it won't be there until 2029.
Hey, we'll be watching, Jana.
We'll be
thank
watching.
You so
thank
much.
You
thanks for having me.